and let us adore Christ. We're so happy that you could all join us this morning on this Sunday, the day after Christmas. It's a quiet morning, a beautiful morning, sunny. And after all of the excitement of yesterday, it's a great morning that we can all spend together. We ask you to say hello to the people that are on Facebook Live who are also joining us. If you want to comment with your prayers or your requests on Facebook and let us know what those are, join us every Sunday on Facebook Live. And have your Bible ready at home and your communion elements available to share with each other. We'd like to ask you to stand and sing with us. We're going to go into our next song called Little Drummer Boy. Here at New Life, Merry Christmas. I'm Kathy Scholl, along with our helpers today. We've got Vern and Dave and Jan and Connie, Brian. We've got Bryce and Bruce and Greg, Iris, George, Rana, and Barb. And yeah, good job, little drummer boy, Bryce. So hello to all of you, and thank you again for joining us on Facebook Live. And isn't our stage beautiful with all the poinsettias? And Queen Turner, our property manager, did a beautiful job of all of the decorations in the red and white. Pastor Heather Hayward is off today and this week for much-deserved rest after all of the wonderful activities that we've had throughout this whole month and during the Advent season. She's shared with us so many great gospel messages about promise fulfilled, joys of peace, faith, hope, and mainly love. These are messages that we can bring with us every day in our lives into a brand new year of 2022 next week. And today there are no New Life Kids, but today is a day that all of God's children, younger and older, can all enjoy. Today's service is going to be kind of fun. It's a special one. It's lessons and carols, and that's just what it sounds like. You can sing along with all of us as we take a journey hearing lessons about the Christmas story, the greatest story ever told. And for our songs during the readings, we'll do one verse each. But first, can we begin with a moment of prayer? Precious Lord God, our Heavenly Father, thank you for sending your Son Jesus to us as a baby, teacher, redeemer, and as our Savior. We know you love us so much, and we are filled with the joys of excitement and happiness, as well as the true joys of love, peace, and contentment. Today, let us savor these gifts from you and share them with others, because that is how we can give love right back to you. Amen. And now we begin with our first reading. You may be seated. Today's first reading comes from Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born to us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall continue to grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. And now we sing Joy to the World.
Our second reading comes from Micah. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel. No origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace.
And we sing, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting
from Luke. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and he said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" And the angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." And then the angel departed from her. The song will be "Angels We've Heard on High."
Angels we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plains, and the mountains in reply echo in their joyous strains. Oh, 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 in at Chelsea's day of
fourth reading is from Matthew. Now the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin will conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had borne a son, and he named him Jesus.
And the song is "What Child Is This?"
For the fifth reading, which is one of my favorites, in that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you a good news of great joy for all the people. To you this day, born in the city of David, a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. And this will be a sign unto you. You will find the child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was an angel of multitudes of heavenly hosts praising God, saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see the thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary, Joseph, and the child lying in a manger. When they saw this, they had made known what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had told him. But Mary treasured these words and pondered them with her in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as been told to them.
And the song is "Hark the Herald Angels Sing."
Sixth reading is from Matthew, second chapter. In the time of King Herod, Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea. Wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where's the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we have observed his star in his rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all of Jerusalem was with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired from them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for this has been written by the prophets, and you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by no means least among the rulers of Judea. For from you shall come the ruler who is to shepherd the people of Israel." Then Herod secretly called the wise men and learned from them the exact time the star had appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go search diligently for the child. And with you have found him. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king say, set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. And entering the house, they saw a child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
And let's go tell it on the mountain.
Go tell it on. Oh,
next reading comes from John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him yet. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he became the power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. If you'd all rise and sing with us, we'll sing this entire song, Love Moved First.
This is the story of a runaway with no way home and no way out. I threw the best of me away. I had my chances too late now. Too far gone and too ashamed to think that you still know my name. But love refused to let my story end that way. You didn't wait for me to find my way to you. I couldn't cross that distance even if I wanted to. You came running after me when anybody else would have turned and left me at my worst. Love moved first. Oh, 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 oh.
The grace, relentless grace. This ram around, crawl into this prisoner's cage. Take my hand and pull me out.
Knew I couldn't make the change,
so you became the change in me. And now I live to tell the story of the God who rescues. You didn't wait for me. That distance, even if I wanted to,
you came running after me.
But anybody else would have turned and left me at my worst. Love moved first
to the manger,
from a manger to the grave. Your cross is the proof. Love made from the grave meant to keep you, to the stone rolled away. Your cross is the proof. Love made the first move.
I remember where you found me. I'm amazed by where I stand. Your cross is the proof that love made the first move.
You didn't wait for me to find my way to you. I couldn't cross that distance even if I wanted to. You came running after me when anybody else would have turned and left me at my worst. Love flew first. Whoa, whoa.
And that is our greatest story ever told. We're so glad that you could share in that with us. And while we're still standing, let's share the peace with one another. Give the high signs. Say hello to people on Facebook, to each other. And then you can be seated. Just a few announcements. So once again, welcome to New Life Church. Our usual traditional worship service is at 8:15, and our Way Cool worship is at 9:30, our praise band worship. So we hope that you'll join us other Sundays in addition to, you know, what you've heard through this Advent season. And it's a welcoming invitation for all of you. Next Sunday, we're going to have some excitement going on here. Pastor Heather will introduce Reverend Walter Barris. He's with the Synod, and he's going to provide our guest sermon message. And we will also introduce our new children and youth ministry coordinator. And her name is Jessica Corrison. I'm looking forward to being able to work with her as well on staff. So we hope that you'll all come and help welcome those people. There's also our first Sunday breakfast, and that's going to be hosted by Debbie and Dennis, and an Epiphany party that's coming up on January 5th, where, you know, there'll be some surprises, White Elephant gifts, some helping take down some of the decorations, and just some nice fellowship there. And as always, you know, we thank you for what you all do and give in this community of New Life Church, your offerings. If you have any end-of-the-year offerings for giving, be sure that you get those postmarked by December 31st. We're always looking for people to help on the welcome team or with the band or with some of the meals that we provide, you know, the Sunday breakfast and the Wednesday meal dinners. Oh, and the AV booth. Oh, yes, Brian is motioning to me that we need people for help on the soundboard, too. So thank you for that. And one other thing, too. Those of you who have ordered these beautiful poinsettias, like Joan, I know you've got one. And after today's service, you can take those home. They've got these beautiful tags with people's names marked on them, so you know which one is yours. Let's just take a little bit of time to spend with our Lord quietly in praise and worship. And joining our voices with the heavenly host and Christians throughout time and space, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. You come to us in gatherings of your church across the globe. Unite us with those who celebrate your birth, even when they're weighed down by grief, loss, poverty, hunger, or injustice. Merciful God, receive our prayer. You come to us in the diverse splendor of the universe. Grant us humility to trust our place in the network of creation, that we live in service to you and the natural world. You come to us through relationships of many kinds that we've experienced throughout these holiday seasons. Joyfulness and gathering with families, friendships, communities, and nations. Guide us in these relationships, that we recognize the Christ child in one another and show your love to those who are most vulnerable. Merciful God, you come to us through people whom the world forgets. Poor shepherds and an imprisoned Paul announced your good news. Send your spirit to all who are imprisoned, struggling with addiction, unwell, or any who are in need on this day. You come to us in acts of justice and forgiveness. Open our hearts to forgive one another without permitting injustice. Supply us with the wisdom to be clothed with love, binding all things together in perfect harmony. And merciful God, hear our personal prayers and intercessions for Margie and Maureen and Janie on the death of her partner, Alice. You come to us through those who have died, yet live with you forever. Rejoice in your word made flesh among us, and we commend these prayers to you, confident of your grace and love, made known to us in Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. And on the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, And after he had given thanks and praise to the Lord, he broke it and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body. Do this to remember me." And after the supper, Jesus took the cup. Once again, he said thanks and praise and said, "Take all of this and drink it. This is my blood given for you. Do this to remember me." And then he asked the disciples to pray, as we'll pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And everyone is welcome to come for our communion and sing Away in a Manger.
Manger, no crib for his bed. The little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky looked down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the
rise for the blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord give you his favor and show you peace. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. One other person I'd like to thank for the poinsettias is Jan for helping us coordinate that and put that together. If we'll all sing together, Love Move First. Oh, we.
That's the one. We just
oh, said. Give this Christmas away.
That's okay.
I'm sorry. Give my mind away. No.
What if I told you have the power to give someone hope beyond their wildest dreams? What if I told you it's right there in your hands? In your hands. It's hard to imagine how something so small can make all the difference, take down the tallest wall. What if December looked different this year? What if we all just give this Christmas away? If there's love in your heart, don't let it stay there. Give this Christmas away, and your life will be changed by the gifts you receive.
Take your poinsettia home, and let's say happy birthday, Pastor Heather.
Oh, happy birthday.
On Tuesday. We love you. Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
If there's love in your heart,
yeah.